Replacing the Serpentine and AC stretch belts on a Ford Focus 2009 to 2010 model Europa. First, you need to remove the AC belt. The easiest way is to cut it off with some snips. Alternatively, you could guide it off the crankshaft pulley. On to removing the Serpentine accessory belt. As before, you can snip the belt off, or on the upper pulley, you could remove the two 10mm bolts and loosen the 13mm nut at the bottom. The pulley will then tilt to the left and allow you to easily remove the belt. On to installing the new belts. In the description below, I have some notes on the new Contitech compatible stretch belts that I used on this install. Place the new Serpentine stretch belt along the original route, making sure the belt ribs align correctly with the pulleys on the crankshaft, water pump, alternator and the upper pulley. Now to lever back home the pulley unit. I used some socket extension arms in the pulley unit hole to give me greater leverage. The lower 13mm nut needs to be slightly loose when doing this procedure to allow the pulley unit to hook over the catch on the engine body. Some force is needed, but nothing too crazy. Place back and tighten the 10mm bolts and the 13mm nut. Back to installing the AC compressor stretch belt. The correct way to do this is using a belt guiding tool whilst turning the crank clockwise. I didn't have that tool, so I went and used the zip ties method. Use two zip ties to hold the belt in place against the crankshaft pulley. Make sure that the zip ties go in between the timing sprocket teeth at the rear of the crankshaft pulley. If those teeth were to be damaged, your engine's timing could be affected. I am turning the crankshaft clockwise with an offset 22mm ring spanner. Keep going until the belt is fully on. If the belt isn't seated properly, you can slightly crank the starter motor to align it into place, but for safety reasons, make sure nobody is close to the pulleys or the belt during this procedure. Put back on the covers and the wheel, and you're done. If you have any comments or questions, please put them below. If the video was useful, please consider giving it a like or subscribing to my channel. Many thanks.